a yin class for you today. That means that we're going to do all our poses with pretty much no effort whatsoever. This means that your breath is a really good clue as to whether you're going too far or not. If you find your breath is compromised, the natural flow of your breath, then you need to back off. Prop yourself a little bit more. Props are your friend. Nothing wrong with props. Comfort is a really good thing here. So watch your breath as we move into these poses. You want to make sure that it's relaxed and easy. No strain anywhere in your body. You might have stretch, you might have sensation, you might even have pleasant discomfort, but you want to make sure there's no strain there. And relaxed breath is your key. So we're going to start off with a great pose for the mid to upper back. Also, just generally very relaxing. I call this the inner tube pose because it's kind of like in the summertime. I don't know if you did this, I did. You lay in an inner tube and just float on down the river. So I'm going to roll up a blanket. The thicker you roll it, the more intense things are. This is going to be the top part of my inner tube where my back will go. I'm going to grab a bolster, and that's going to be the bottom part of my inner tube. So this is the part where my butt hangs down into the water. So I'm going to take my knees over that bottom part. I'm going to position my upper part so it's right under the bottom edge of my shoulder blades. Kind of like you're going to drape your arms over the edge of the inner tube and just lay back. This makes it a very nice release for that mid and upper back. Adjust yourself any way you need to for maximum comfort. One of the things about yin poses, or this is more of a restorative pose than a yin pose, thanks to the props, but one of the things about all these poses is it's all about relaxing into it. So we spend some extra time there so all of those tissues can release and so that mind can begin to release. And maybe your puppy will give you some extra love. And now just let it go. Let your breath be natural. Let your thoughts race as much as they need to. And just be with whatever arises, physical, mental, or emotional. Some distractions in your environment or mind, but just be with what arises. Soften and let go. Take just a few more breaths here. We'll gather our arms in and bend the knees. And roll onto our side. And lift ourselves up just enough to remove the props from underneath us. And we're going to give it a little twist to the body. So lay yourself back down on your back. Take your arms out wide. Take the soles of your feet to the floor wide apart, knees bent. And just release the knees over to one side. Turn your head to the other side. Top underneath your knee, top knee if you need it. The right place for a block. Notice your breath. Remember, it should be easy and free. And let go into your pose. Noticing the subtle details as they become apparent. The release of the shoulder. The beat of your heart. And gently roll the head to center, the knees to center. Moving any props you may have used, adjusting anything that needs adjusting. And then releasing your knees to the other side, turning the head. Relaxing into whatever gifts this side may bring you. Drawing your eyes and your knees to center. And rolling all the way onto your belly. And pay a little bit more attention to that upper back here. Also to the fascial connections of the low back and the front of the spine. So bring your elbows right under your shoulders. Your palms can be together, or you can place your palms on the floor. Bring your toes and kneecaps in slightly. Draw the shoulders gently away from the ears. You don't want to sink all the way down and crunch your neck. So just a little bit of effort there to maintain the length of your neck. And drop your low front ribs towards the floor. Noticing where you can soften, where you might be using more effort than you need to. Let that go.
and your head all the way down on the floor. And you're ready, hands under your shoulders, pressing to all fours, and then coming all the way down onto your bottom. If you like to sit on a blanket, this is a good time to grab that. If you find your hamstrings are really tight and you'd like a blanket under your knees, it's a good time for that too. Moving any flesh you can find out of the way. Relax your legs and hinge forward at your hips, Paschimottanasana. Now, if your spine is dealing with any osteoporosis issues, any disc issues, then you want to keep it relatively straight. You can use your hands to support you. Otherwise, you can let your back round and your head droop. Resist that urge to pull yourself deeper. Just let what happens happen. If your belly feels like it's restricting you, it's okay. Let it restrict you. Let the breath massage your organs. Couple more breaths. And using your hand to press you all the way up. Taking in the effects of your posture. Preparing yourself for another forward fold. And this one was going to be asymmetrical, working into the hips a little bit more. We're going to take pigeon pose. So come on up to all fours. You're going to take that left knee forward. And we're going to take it a little bit out to the side. So that left heel comes in front of your right hip. You can wiggle your hips back a little bit. You want them to stay relatively square here. Walk your hands forward. Find a place where everything feels supported, just enough that it can relax. You can let go of the effort. This might mean that you're not at your deepest stretch. This might mean that you find yourself breathing a little deeper, but remember, no strain. Soften wherever you can. breath, use your hands to lift the torso. Slowly slide that left leg back. Check out what you feel in there. You might want a little movement. And then we'll try out that other side. So we're going to take the right knee forward and then a little out to the side so that that right heel comes in front of the left hip. Move the hips back if that feels really good to you. And then we're going to make sure those hips can square. And we're going to fold forward. Positioning the hands, the body, in such a way that you feel like you can let go and relax. And just seeing how the second side feels. And you might be able to let go a little bit more. Attention here for the length of the spine as well as the hips. So we come into half moon. So move your legs over to the left. You can cross your ankles if you'd like. You can move your shoulders over to the left too if you feel like you need a deeper opening. And draw your arms up by your ears. Go ahead and hold that right wrist with your left hand. And relax into the breath. Relax into the sensations. Your sensations are really strong. You might back up a little bit. So begin to notice the subtleties of this posture. Noticing where you can let go even a tiny bit more. Arms down first, shifting the shoulders to center, and then shifting the legs to center. And before we feel too lopsided, we're going to shift the legs over to the right, crossing the right ankle over left. You might shift your shoulders to the right too. And then bring your arms up by your ears. Holding your left wrist with your right hand. Letting your breath and your position do all the work. Let go of all the rest. The arms, move the shoulders to center. Slowly move the legs back to center. And just take a moment because that gets into some interesting parts of your deeper hip flexors and belly. Some places that sometimes the tension really supports your low back. So just make sure that that all feels stable. And when you're sure, roll yourself to one side. And come on up onto all fours. You're going to need your bolster here. And you might find you need some other props too. We're going to come into a reclining hero. And this is a different pose for everyone. We all have our tight areas. So if you need support under your ankles, roll a blanket under your ankles. If you need support under your bottom, grab a block. I'm going to take my feet to the outside of my hips as I sit back here. That usually means, for me anyway, moving my calves out of the way. This way my bottom can sit right down on the floor. Your bottom might not want to sit all the way on the floor, in which case, you know, slide something else underneath there. You want to make sure it's not just suspended in space. That's really challenging for your knees. If your knees don't like this, give it up. Take Shavasana. That's where we're all going next. I'm going to take my bolster, short end towards my bottom, and lie all the way back. Now, it's not always comfortable for everyone to lie all the way back. So, you know, multiple bolsters, a whole tower of bolsters can be really nice. I particularly like this version with the bolster behind me because then it gets into the lower belly area that we began to find with our reclining half moon. It's a nice way to release tension there, which helps with digestion, elimination, easing menstrual cramps, all kinds of good stuff. Arms can go wherever it feels good. And we relax and breathe. This can be a big posture for a lot of folks. So if you're one of those people that this is huge and relaxing and breathing sounds impossible, let it go. And just come into whatever Shavasana feels good for you. And we'll join you soon. No point torturing yourself. You'll just hurt yourself if you torture yourself. Relax. Breathe. Let go. Take a few more breaths here.
come up, we're gonna use our belly. So gather a little bit of energy. Use your hands and your elbows too. And come up nice and straight. We're gonna release that bolster from behind us. And we're ready for Shavasana. So slowly unkink yourself. And lie all the way down on your back. Propping where you lie. So that you can just let go. Staying present. Whatever you find inside. Relaxing and letting go within that presence. Fully aware, fully relaxed. Gathering a little energy for movement. Deepening your breath. And eventually rolling to your side. At some point, coming all the way up to seated. Inhaling your arms overhead. Exhaling your palms together in front of your heart. Centering yourself for the rest of your day. Thank you for joining me today. Thank you for sharing of this practice. Namaste. Jai Bhagavan.